Ciao a tutti e benvenuti in questo nuovo video. Io sono Fiona, mi trovo in compagnia di Catherine Ladus, che è il direttore della comunicazione EMEA di Lenovo. Hello Catherine.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno, che brava l'ha detto in italiano. Ci troviamo in questo momento all'iniziativa STEM in the City, in cui Lenovo è sponsor, tra gli sponsor. So first of all, please Catherine, I would really like you to introduce yourself and help us understand better what is the meaning of your job title.
Okay, so first of all, we are very pleased, you know, in Lenovo to support this event. I think it's a great initiative. And so I am Catherine Ladus, you say very well my name. I am a leading communication in Europe, Middle East, Africa. So Italy is part, of course, of the, I would say, the market that I am looking for. And I am in charge of communication.
So you actually, I don't know, decide what will be Lenovo's face somehow?
I don't know if we decide, but we can influence. You know, it's a job where you influence quite a lot of people. You influence the president, you influence, you know, the different, you know, people we can take action, because also we reflect the market. You know, we are the voice mainly of the many targets, you know, which are in the ecosystem of a company. And a company, you know, of course, to succeed, need to make sure that there is a strong confidence with the employee, confidence with the management, confidence with the customer, because, you know, they are buying our products, they are buying our services, and confidence with the partners. So we are the person, I think, we are sometimes between, you know, all the different targets. And our role, I don't say that we decide, but I think we have a strong influence.
So I know you work for different types of companies. So what are the differences between banking companies, for example, and tech companies? You worked for Crédit Agricole, that's right?
Yeah, I work for Crédit Agricole and American Express Bank. I think, you know, the communication job, sometimes we say the principles are the same, and the job could be, I would say, the same, you know, because we are not expert of a sector. We are expert about, you know, the ability to translate also the message of the company. So from one side, I say, okay, I work during 10 years in the banking industry and I moved to IT. I'm not an expert of IT. But what I think is a big difference is that, of course, the sector of banking needed to transform, and they transform themselves. But I can tell you, when you join a tech company, you know, the innovation is always, you know, here, because the only way to really succeed is really by innovation. So which is very appealing, you know, when we join a tech company, is that first you meet a lot of talent. Sometimes, you know, the people, we are the guru, you know, of technology, and so we arrive with a fantastic product, they love their product, and us, we are here to portray this product to our different target. So it's very exciting, it's moving very fast, sometimes really faster than the banking industry, and it might be a little bit more fun, I think so.
So I know one day you realized that the gender gap was a problem inside companies. So when this happened and what did you do?
I think I realized, you know, there was a gender gap when I joined, for example, IBM. And IBM was a company with a lot of talent, but it showed that the presence of the woman was the ratio of a woman in the team, in the different, you know, job, was quite low when I joined, you know, 20 years ago. And that was my first, you know, feeling. So, but why? Coming from the bank, you know, in the bank you have much more women, you know, in the workforce. But right now in the tech company, you can have us in Lenovo, we have 34% of women, which is quite higher than the average, but the average is more between 15% to 25%. And this question of gender gap is not only IBM, not only Lenovo, is all the company we are in the tech industry are now, you know, considering that we are all fighting for talent and we don't want, you know, to have the over competitor taking the talent that we want, and we need absolutely to do something to be much more attractive, you know, vis-a-vis to the women, because we need them.
So, in a concrete way, what did you do to gather all those women?
I think there is a lot of tactic, you know, and practice. First, we share also the practice across the industry, and that is really important. So, for example, 16 years ago, I created in France a network of women and men, you know, committed to really promote, you know, the mixity and to close the gender gap. In the different industry, you know, we are in the sector of technology and scientific and technology. First, to share best best practice, because the objective is first we need to attract and then you need to retain them, you know, because otherwise they are living, you know, outside. And of course, in the kind of company, we sometimes the image is less glamour, you know, than the company we are working in, I don't know, in fashion or in the, you know, luxe and so on. So we need the first to make some effort in terms of portray the company, in terms of campaign, even, you know, how you write a job, you know, to make sure it is not gender, you know, in a way that it can attract, you know, women and men. And also to have some specific campaign, for example, in Lenovo, last September, we launched a digital hiring campaign targeting women and using the women from Lenovo to share their own experience and telling, please join us, because we are not enough. But also, which is really important, is all the actions that we can do internally. So we have a networking activity, we have sponsoring, I would say getting a sponsor, getting a mentor. We have, for example, program on mentoring, and which are really targeting top talent, you know, to make sure that they will feel, I would say they will strengthen, you know, their personality, to also have the courage also sometimes to ask for a promotion, because that is really important.
So will you encourage young girls to start STEM studies?
Yes, sure, because there is a lot of opportunity, you know, all the company, not only the tech company, but all the company are now transforming the digital world. So there is a lot of needs for the skills, you know. We are, of course, dedicated to provide, you know, this value and to really help, you know, and work in this area. So first, I think I will encourage the young girls, because right now they will be a minority and everybody wants to get, you know, women, you know, in their team. So it's a huge opportunity for them, because there is a lot of jobs, you know, which are created. And so I think that I will really encourage, you know, the girls. And also we need to, that is our challenge and our responsibility as a tech company, to show that there is a lot of women who can make a great career, you know, in our industry. That was the purpose of the women campaign that I made, to show, you know, that we are not the geek with, you know, the image, you know, that you can imagine and you say, no, I don't want to be with that. We are a woman, we are elegant, we are, you know, love to do also, you know, love technology, but love a lot of things, and feel that it's a platform and it's an environment where we can be successful.
The last question is, in companies like Lenovo, there is room for girls who didn't do STEM studies, so which are not so technical.
Yes, sure. You know, the large part of the, I think, the success of a company, of course, there is a part of the engineer, you know, and the engineer part. This you need to have, you know, technical skills, this is sure. But I can tell you, who is a CEO right now is a sales guy, you know. You don't need, you know, to be an expert, you know. You become, of course, now you know the product, but you don't need to have to study STEM to sell a product, to sell a PC, you know, or to sell, you know, a smartphone. And I think, and anyway, it's a kind of a job. So we have people coming from business school, people coming from the different, you know, studies, and we have from a lawyer or, you know, anything that I think help you to have the capacity to understand the needs of the customer, you know, and then, you know, you can learn, you know, well, is the technical part as soon as you are ready. And of course, in marketing, well, in communication.
So thank you very much, Catherine, for being here with me, and just say ciao.
Ciao.